Hi, welcome to Chronic Kidney Disease Program at University of California, San Diego. My name is Danuta Trzebinska and I'm a nephrologist in our clinic. In this module, we'll talk about laboratory values for chronic kidney disease. It is important that you track and understand your lab values. We already talked about creatinine in the previous module. Creatinine is a waste product from the muscle, which is normally removed by the kidneys. The level in the blood rises when kidneys do not function well. GFR, or glomerular filtration rate, is calculated based on your creatinine, and it estimates percent of normal kidney function. Blood urea nitrogen, also known as BUN, or some patients like to call it BUN. It's a waste product from dietary protein, which is removed by the kidneys. BUN, or BUN, is also used to estimate the level of kidney function, but it is less reliable than creatinine. It can be affected by how much fluid one drinks and some other variables, so we prefer to focus more on creatinine. Let's move on to electrolytes and acid-base balance in the blood. Most people know that too much sodium is not good for you. Unfortunately, the level of sodium in the blood does not reflect how much sodium you're eating. You might be eating three times as much as you should, as an average American does, yet your measured level will remain normal at the expense of drinking more fluid to dilute this extra sodium and possibly elevating your blood pressure and putting extra strain on your heart. Some people can, however, develop abnormal level of sodium in the blood due to either poorly functioning heart or kidneys or liver or some hormonal disturbances. Normal level of sodium is between 135 and 145. Potassium is a mineral in your blood that helps your heart and muscles work properly. If the level is too high, it can change your heartbeat and lead to potentially dangerous arrhythmia. Normal range is between 3.5 to 5.1. If potassium level in your blood gets to be too high, we'll educate you how to avoid foods which are high in potassium and use medications to help maintain healthy potassium level. Now, bicarbonate. Bicarbonate is a measure of acidity of your blood. Patients with chronic kidney disease often cannot excrete acid generated from metabolism of foods that they ingest. Mainly, it comes from protein, and they develop metabolic acidosis. So what? Metabolic acidosis, big deal, right? Well, it is a big deal. Metabolic acidosis, also known as too much acid or too little base, can lead to muscle breakdown. No one wants to have weak muscle, right? It can also lead to weak bones, and it can speed up the progression of chronic kidney disease. Normal value for bicarbonate is between 22 and 29. If your level is below that, your nephrologist might prescribe baking soda or similar type of medication to correct it, to neutralize extra acid in your body and thus protect your muscle, protect your bones, and slow down the progression of chronic kidney disease. The next three laboratory values have to do with bone health. They can be adversely affected by kidney disease and lead to weak bones. Calcium and phosphorus are important for strong bones. Abnormal levels of calcium and phosphorus, besides leading to bone disease, believe it or not, they can get deposited in your blood vessels, heart, and other organs and cause damage as well. Normal levels for those minerals might slightly vary depending on the laboratory, but usually are 8.6 to 10.5 milligrams per deciliter for calcium and 2.7 to 4.5 for phosphorus. We will help you maintain normal calcium and normal phosphorus levels with appropriate diet, and if needed, we use some medications. Now, parathyroid hormone, also known as PTH, and not to be confused with thyroid hormone or TSH. This is something different. So PTH regulates movement of calcium and phosphorus between your blood, bones, and also affects the excretion in the urine. The acceptable level for PTH depends on the stage of kidney disease. So you will have to check with your doctor what's the appropriate level for you. If your PTH gets to be too high, we'll prescribe special type of vitamin D, which will bring it down to more healthy levels. We are moving on now to laboratory values for anemia. Hemoglobin is part of red blood cells that carries oxygen from your lungs to all parts of the body. Hemoglobin is used to diagnose anemia. The target range for hemoglobin in patients with CKD is somewhere between 9.5 to 11, and it's kind of a moving target. But for now, this is what it is. If your hemoglobin level is below this range, your doctor might prescribe special medication that will help your body produce more blood. We also periodically measure your iron stores. Iron stores are very important. Iron is a necessary building block for red blood cells. Should you be iron deficient, your doctor will likely prescribe either iron pills or intravenous infusion to correct this deficiency. Let's talk about cholesterol for a moment. Everyone knows about cholesterol, right? Cholesterol is a fat-like substance that is found in all cells of the body. Your body certainly needs some cholesterol, but if present in excess, it can lead to heart disease. Normal cholesterol level is considered to be under 200. There are two basic types of cholesterol. HDL, also known as good cholesterol, you get a smiley face for this. It has protective properties to the heart, so you want this number pretty high. One of the ways to increase HDL is by exercise, and we'll talk about this more. LDL, also known as bad cholesterol, does not get a smiley face. It can contribute to heart disease, so you want this number on a lower side. Your doctor might ask you to take cholesterol medication even if your level of cholesterol is under 200, so normal, right? The reason is that patients with CKD are at high risk for heart disease, regardless of cholesterol level. As I mentioned in the previous module, protecting your heart is our number one priority. Yes, we are kidney doctors. Yes, we care about kidneys, but heart comes first. A triglyceride is another type of fat found in your blood, and if elevated, it might increase your risk of heart disease. It's usually measured at the same time as we measure cholesterol. We are now done going over various blood tests and are ready to focus on testing of the urine. In the normal state of kidney health, there should be no blood, no protein, and no bacteria in the urine. Nothing like that. Presence of blood or protein cannot be detected with a naked eye. That's why we ask you to submit urine sample to the lab for a more precise microscopic measurements. If your kidneys are spilling protein in the urine, we'll run an extra test to quantify how much protein is being wasted. Protein in the urine, also known as proteinuria, if you want to sound like a nephrologist, can, over time, cause damage to your kidneys. Whenever possible, we use medications to decrease the amount of protein in the urine and to protect your kidneys. Besides checking blood and urine tests, your nephrologist will likely want to have a picture of your kidneys. This is done to make sure that you have two kidneys. Yes, some people are born with just one kidney and they don't know about this. It's an incidental finding. And we also want to make sure that there is no obstruction or abnormal cyst in your kidneys. Depending on your situation, you might be asked to do either a kidney ultrasound, which is pretty simple, or a little bit more sophisticated test like CAT scan or even MRI. Let's do two questions to test your understanding of this module. Question number one. What blood tests do we use to estimate level of kidney function or GFR? Is it A, sodium, or B, potassium, or C, creatinine, or D, phosphorus? All right, let's think about this for a second. And the correct answer is C, or creatinine. Creatinine is used to calculate GFR. All right, are you guys ready for question number two? How much protein should be present in the urine? Option A, none. Option B, some, but not too much. And let's see, option C, the more, the better. All right, which one is it? Okay, and the correct answer is that there should be absolutely no protein in the urine. Protein in the urine is a risk factor for worsening kidney function over time. We do everything we can to minimize the amount of protein in the urine. Congratulations, you have completed the module on laboratory values for chronic kidney disease. Please check our website for additional educational modules on kidney health.